guys, welcome back to another video. In today's episode, we'll be playing some more Red Dead Redemption. In this episode, we'll be doing an Agent Ross mission, if I'm correct. Yeah, it's an Agent Ross mission, and we're just going to go there right now, so hopefully the mission's on. And hopefully it is, so just walking over here right now. But yeah, it's on.
What do you want, Marston?
My family. I've done what you asked.
No, you haven't. This is the land of opportunity, and I gave you the opportunity to save your family, and you failed. How could I possibly reward you?
Marston, you're a public menace. We should have had you killed.
I wish you had. But since you didn't, where's my family?
Oh, spare me the noble savage falling a sword tripe, will you, old boy? It's nauseating. You don't wish to be dead. You're an insignificant creature desperately clinging on to life like the rest of the scum in this town. Yeah, I know it's tough. You like Dutch. He's a charming fellow. He makes sense. He's like one of those nature writers from back east, only he takes things a tiny little step too far. Rather than just loving the flowers and the animals and the harmony between man and beast, he shoots people in the head for money and disagreeing with them.
He's a goddamn killer.
Now, I'm not a great intellect, but the metaphysical leap from admiring the flower to shooting a man in the head because he doesn't like the flower is a leap too far. So, I know it's easy. You see, me and Archer, we're the bad guys. We enforce the rules. Now, while the rules may not be perfect, they're really not so bad.
Exactly. What's the alternative?
I'll tell you what the alternative is. It's not complicated. It's about one man and his gun versus another man. Sure, civilization may be dull, but the alternative, Mr. Marston, is hell.
And the way you enforce this civilization, this freedom for men to like or not like flowers or whatever in God's name you were just talking about, is to kidnap a man's wife and son?
Well, I know there's contradictions. I'm not going to lie to you. Yeah, as I said, I'm not a great intellect. Now, after the debacle with the army and the bank, we have to put Mr. Vanderlyn to rest ourselves. Will you help us?
Do I have any choice?
Now that you mention it, no.
Then what was that pretty speech in aid of?
I don't rightly know, but it sure felt good saying it.
Shall we, Mr. Marston?
Let's go.
Okay, so we're on here right near right now on this turret, and I think we're gonna kill some people. God, I always say turret. I don't know why, but we're about to go kill some people right here. So I will just skip to destination because I can't be bothered to go through all this.
Machine gun. What's the word, Captain?
We spotted one of Dutch's men about an hour ago. I think he took the bait.
Let's get in position then. Have your men ready to run them down if you have to.
Dismiss! Load weapons and get to the sandbag!
Are you ready to finish this, Mr. Marston?
I guess so.
Okay, so they should be coming just in a few secs. There we are, so I can't see him, but yeah, I can see one horse. There we are, so just gotta take him down. I don't like these turret missions, but of course we have to do them. Now we don't have any medicine, do we?
Take him down. Kill those bastards. Hold them off.
I thought you wanted to kill.
So some of them have dynamite. But it's really the horses we want to be taking out.
Keep it steady. Look, they're running. Move out. Don't let them get away.
So I think we're going into the woods because there's some bandits in the rocks as well. There we are, and there's one with dynamite right here that we need to take out. There we go. Gonna be taking a lot of heavy damage. And of course I die. Great. Yes, so we survived that, and we can keep going this time.
We should have done this a long time ago.
Okay, so there's a few right here, and a few here. And one more, like, right here. There we go. So I think there's still going to be a lot more as we progress through the woods. Hold on, what is that wagon?
That wagon's out of control! It's coming straight out of the cavalry!
There we are, we just blew that up.
Everyone out of the front turret!
Whoa.
Well, Mr. Marston, it seems like your mentor Dutch no longer looks quite so kindly to his student.
That man is insane.
So it seems.
I think we need to get him before sundown.
As you say, Captain. Otherwise, he'll be gone again.
And what if I say no?
Now, before I shoot you myself, let me just point out the obvious. The one person we have left that can appeal to Mr. Vanderlyn is the last person we know who knows him. Your wife.
That won't be necessary. Mr. Ross, Captain, let's go.
Okay, so we got to mount our horse, and I think we're going somewhere else. Ride to Cockinary. Okay. Cockinary.
So you're the one who's gonna kill him?
Dutch? Yep, that's what they keep telling me. But if you feel like doing it, please be my guest.
We're just gonna keep riding all the way to there. And this is the snow biome area, if I can remember. I always used to hunt bears here when I played the game quite a lot. Rack up quite a lot of money from doing it. I tried to get the explosive shotgun, but I didn't manage to do that. Actually, it's called the explosive rifle, because if I can remember, you need like, what is it, $3,000, $5,000 to buy that, and it was real powerful, so yeah. So hopefully we're able to make it here. It's not too long.
Let's go.
So I think we're almost there. Whoa, I just fell straight into here. Yeah, I'm really bad when it comes to bridges in this game. So you'll really see me fail quite a lot near those areas. I was nearly about to fall off again. So it's very dark over in this area. And here we are, we've made it. So we're over in that place that we found at the start of the game. Not the start, I mean like over when we did that mission with the professor. Okay, so we're making it inside Dutch's gang's place, so we'll be able to take him out. Oh, why have I got my fists equipped? There we are. Well, why did I pick the berries? I wanted to pick the corpse. There we are. Now we can get all that money. Right, crouch. There we go. Okay, so one last body to loot. There we go, then we've got all them to kill. Wow, only because I couldn't get out of cover. You know, I really need to fix the cover mechanics in this game.
It's time to kill these motherless bastards!
You know, I'm just gonna go and I'm not gonna loot the corpses. Yeah, I died again. Alright, so hopefully we can make it through now. Right, I need to cover these men planting the bombs. There we are. So hopefully we're gonna get in.
You tend to your wounded. I gotta face Dutch alone.
So I'm facing Dutch alone then. Right, so I need to kill Dutch's guards. Why does it keep sucking me into that one? Alright. So... okay, so we nearly got him.
idea what you're killing for?
You never could see what I could see, John. You were too scared. You'll never get me to surrender.
Wow, I can't even do these boss battles anymore. Killed Dutch's guards. Can't survive this, can I? Alright.
You'll never take me alive, John.
Right, so we're chasing Dutch now. Climbing up here. Okay, so we've nearly made it up here.
I ain't like you.
All right, so need to climb up this one. Then this one. There we go. We'll eventually get to kill him. Here we are, so we almost got him now.
It won't make it go away. That's where you're wrong.
There's no way for him out.
Meeting like this.
Sure.
I got a plan, John.
You always got a plan, Dutch.
This is a good one.
I don't doubt it.
We can't always fight nature, John. We can't fight change. Can't fight gravity. We can't fight nothing. My whole life, all I ever did was fight.
Then give up, Dutch.
But I can't give up, neither. I can't fight my own nature. That's a paradox, John. You see?
Then I have to shoot you.
When I'm gone, they'll just find another monster. They have to. Because they have to justify their wages.
That's their business.
Our time has passed, John.
So at the end, you didn't have the guts to shoot him.
The man's dead, Ross.
Sure. Can I see your gun? Hmm. trust me. It looks better in the report that way.
Where's my family?
Your wife was killed in a prison riot last week. So, I'm only joking, dear boy. They were sent back to that Scrabble ranch of yours in Beecher's Hope. They're quite safe and sound.
They better be.
Thank you, Mr. Marston, for everything. I know this wasn't easy for you, but I have to say, you've done your country proud.
Yeah, exactly. See you around, John. Try to stay out of trouble. Come on, Archer. Let's go find somebody else we can annoy.
Okay, so that was a pretty long episode, guys, but I hope you guys enjoy. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you all later. Bye.